comprar mis cosas. Aquí te veo. Anda, con cuidado. Tráemelo. Déjalo a la puerta.
Mire, ven.
No te caigo por él.
Voy a decirte.
No
te caigo.
Hang on, I'll drive.
Comiencen el ataque.
Están por llegar los refuerzos. Eliminen a esa gente de inmediato.
Get down!
Enemiga localizada. A todas las unidades diríjanse a esas coordenadas.
Frag out. Come mierda, culeros.
That was a civilian, not a Sicario.
Go.
Empty hopes that can only be achieved through tyranny.
I'm in. Let's go.
People can only be equal when equality is forced upon them. That Qatari would take the fruit of your labor, take the largest portion for himself, and the divide what is left between you and your neighbor. Tengan cuidado. You would not reap what you have sown. You would be left with barely anything. Best way, the only moral and Christian way to bring success and prosperity to the individual citizen and the nation is through a free economy. Contrary to the lies spread by Pacatari and his kind.
So how brutal is Yuri and Polito's torture anyway? I sure as hell don't want to find out. But I mean, obviously it's nothing as softball as waterboarding, right? I mean, we're talking permanent damage and death here.
They're also medically trained, so you have to figure there are some pharmaceuticals at work to keep their victims awake.
See, back in the day, the real torturers didn't need drugs to keep their victims awake. So they're amateurs.
That's obvious from how few people survive their interrogations. A real torturer, a professional. He or she is in control. He or she understands what's needed. Yuri and Polito are sloppy. They get carried away. They do it for the fun of it, not because it's a job and not for the art. So yes, they're brutal, but not because they try to be. They're brutal because they're incompetent.
You got a dark side hidden under that smile, don't you?
The Santa Blanca cartel is making large strides in purging the country of your rebel menace. We can't do it alone. Este insulso de Pacatari and his rebels, autodefensas, talk crazy
about
our poverty, of putting control of the country's destiny in the hands of the farmer. But Pacatari lies. Men like him make their promises, give you hope. But all they want is power, control. You've seen it all across the continent. But Santa Blanca has put your destiny as an individual back in your own hands. This is the reality of today. Not some fantasy tomorrow you have to hope for. Es ahora, banda. No party, no union is around to tell you how to run your life. We have given Bolivia the investment and the jobs that have helped you improve your lives. But Pacatari and his rebels threaten
to save this way of life. Get your fucking head on straight.
There might be some
intel around here.
We will do our part, but you must do yours. Do not support Pacatari and his rebels. Report any rebel activity directly to your local Santa Blanca organization. We can defeat the rebel menace.
Santa Blanca.
The Santa Blanca cartel is making large strides in purging the country of your rebel menace. We can't do it alone. Este insulso de Paca. Like him, make their promises, give you hope, but all they want is power.
Weapons free, weapons free.
Sorry about this, brother, but I gotta have the car. Out.
Do yours. Do not support Pacatari and his rebels. Report any rebel activity directly to your local Santa Blanca organizations. Juntos, we can defeat the rebel menace.
This is Lydia Flores. If you're a puchona like I am, your entire life people have called you bossy. Madonna. For me, my mother. mother was the first person to call me Mandona. Then it was the other niños at school. As I got older, it was boyfriends, co-workers, and let's be honest, my mother has never stopped calling me Mandona. People say it's because they expect a woman to be pleasant and sweet. O sea, there are even some women out there, successful women, who want to ban the actual word bossy. But people who are satisfied being pleasant, who don't act bossy, even if they don't like the word, they don't get what they fucking want. They don't make millions of dollars a month shipping products all over the world. They don't have a hacienda or hundreds of sicarios ready to die for them. So chicas, be mandonas, be bossy. If you're una cuivida and you're not una cabrona, you won't ever be the fucking boss.
Esto es Ese Vato.
Radio Santa Blanca, con DJ Perico.
¡Dale, vato loco!
¿Qué pasa, plebe? DJ Perico playing that music that makes your culito bounce up and down. But now, we're taking a break for a public service announcement. Do not betray Santa Blanca. You do not fuck with El Sueño, wey! Here is a brief recording of what Jorge and Inca Camina has to say on the topic.
Por favor! Mercy! Mercy!
I will
We need dead soldiers by the road up ahead. Looks like a traffic detail.
And there you have it, Raza! Do not fuck with Santa Blanca. And now, an old favorite going out to Jorge. Be the 10th caller with the correct name of the song and win Jorge's gold watch.
Boom it. We're in Bucara.
You know that annoying DJ Perico on Santa Blanca Radio? The activity has narrowed the location of his main broadcasting station to Bucara, so Perico himself should be close.
What do we want with him?
We need you to use your unique charm to convince DJ Perico to broadcast a Pacatari speech. It's a move that'll both raise the rebels' profile and make the cartel look bad.
Persuade, change, and influence, huh? No leads on poop. Hold up.
I'm opening fire. Cartel sent reinforcements.
Took you so long.